Hello, this is my first Let's Play video with audio. Pretty exciting. I'm going to be experimenting with it just by playing Skyrim, a familiar game to many, I'm sure. The sound is a little loud, so I'm going to modify the volume of the music. But otherwise, I've done some tests and it sounds like it's fine. Currently, I'm in the middle of the main quest, which I've never played through before, so I guess I can consider this a blind playthrough. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 notches. Hopefully then you can hear me. There's a little fizzing in the audio. That's because I had to turn my microphone up to the maximum levels to be heard. But maybe this will help as well. Okay, I'm playing a full mage character. I just spoke with the dragon for the first time. We're going to... what do you think?
So, you spoke to Bartimaeus. The dragon blood burns bright within you. Did he tell you what you wanted to know? Did he teach you the dragonrend shout? So be it. If he believes it is necessary for you to learn this, we will bow to his wisdom. We have never concerned ourselves with the scrolls. The gods themselves would rightly fear to tamper with such things. As for where to find it, such blasphemies have always been the stock and trade of the mages of Winterhold. They may be able to tell you something about the Elder Scroll you seek.
It's a good thing I'm the Archmage of Winterhold.
Sky? Gotcha.
Get used to my camera control because, of course, up and down are reversed in the last game that I was playing. Okay, so we're in High Hrothgar right now. You can't really see the area below. It's kind of covered by clouds, but we just came from the top of the mountain where we spoke to the dragon. If you see one of my party members bouncing, there's a mod effect that's on him, and it's acting a little wonky right now. I used to have the mod on, and then he's a custom follower. He came from a mod himself, and he seems to be acting wonky with another mod that I had on previously. So that's why he's sort of like jittering. Hopefully that won't get to be an annoyance. The last thing I'm going to do before I fast travel is something that if you're playing on PC, you might not even know you could do at all. But the visual settings of Skyrim are not optimized for a 1920 by 1080p monitor. You can fix that by going into the console commands, like so, and type FOV space 80. There, that's better. You might be like, well, in third person, isn't that just like zooming the camera out? Well, where it's important is more so first person, where you'll see there's quite a bit of space to the left and right of the hands. Okay, but let us go on our merry way. The College of Winterhold calls us now. I'm the Archmage, but to be honest, there's a charming old man in the College of Winterhold that I much would have preferred to be Archmage than me. I'm just a lowly noob when it comes to magic. Well, I've got myself some adept spells, so maybe noob isn't the right word.
You're not as dumb
Hold
as you
up
look.
There,
what are
buddy.
You looking at?
I'm looking for an Elder Scroll.
And what do you plan to do with it? Do you even know what you're asking about? Or are you just someone's errand girl? think that even if I did have one here, I would let you see it?
I'm the arch.
It would be kept
buddy.
Under the highest security. The greatest thief in the world wouldn't be able to lay a finger on it. What about? Wait. Are you? Were you the one the Greybeards were calling? I'll bring everything we have on them. But it's not much. So don't get your hopes up. It's mostly lies, leavened with rumor and conjecture.
Mm-hmm. Okay, buddy, let's go. Go your way. Do you need something?
I'm not one for commendations, but I might have lost everything that matters, so thanks. Fight well.
Should be said that I've already completed the entire, College of Winterhold quests. This guy really should be speaking to me as my inferior. What are you doing? You gathering information or something?
Here you go. Try not to spill anything on them.
Effects of the Elder Scrolls. I already read this sucker, buddy. But I'll take it. Ruminations of the Elder Scrolls. Ask Rug about this insane book. Where are you, buddy? Where did you go? Get the heck back here. Sorry, I'm not sure if I want this to be child-friendly video or not yet, so I'm not really
need
sure
something.
About how much I'm gonna swear.
What do you want?
Hey, buddy. Okay, get back here.
Okay, this better be good. Aye, that's the work of Septimus Cygnus. He's the world's master of the nature of Elder Scrolls, but, well, he's been gone for a long while. Too long. Somewhere up north, in the ice fields. He said he found some old Dwemer artifact, but, well, that was years ago. Haven't heard from him since.
Okay. Oh, I've been up there. Isn't that convenient? I suppose I should take some time to introduce you guys to the team. Up first is Lydia, who, because I'm an Argonian, I would like Argonian followers, so I'm actually using a mod that makes her an Argonian herself. But, sadly, all of her sass is intact. Next is good ol' Fandol, who you'll hear me refer to as Flannel. That's my name for him. It dates back years. He is unmodded, except he does have a custom mask, the Majora's Mask, which gives him a lot more light armor. It's pretty cool, too. And next up in order of when they join me, this buggy guy, is Anshir, a custom Argonian mod, who trust me, normally does not bounce all over the place, but unfortunately, one of the mods he has, or he's got modded equipment on him, which Lydia has too, but whereas she's not bouncing up and down, poor Anshir is. Don't really know how to solve that, but I'm leaving it for now. And then finally we have Frelina, who I'm sure I'll have some nickname for in the future, but I don't have one quite yet. She's a mage. And she's a light armor knight. Lydia is a heavy armor knight. And good old Flannel is my trusty archer. Frelina, I actually added somewhat recently. I don't know if I'm going to keep her on, but she's actually, I mean, I don't have any reason not to currently, so. Oh, yes. And then there's me, Swanfa. But, actually, weather like this, I don't really roleplay very much in Skyrim, but when it's cold, I like to put on something a little more warm, like hood or something. Of course, check this out. Morokay's mask is super cool. Makes me look like a plague doctor. I think I'll keep it on for now. Okay. On the PlayStation 3 I was here, but I don't remember what for. It wasn't for this quest, it was for something else.
When the top level was built, no more could be placed. It was, and is, the maximal apex. Elder Scrolls, indeed. The Empire, they absconded with them. So they think, the ones they saw. The ones they thought they saw. I know of one. Forgotten. Sequestered. But I cannot go to it. Not poor Septimus. For I have arisen beyond its grasp. Here. Well, here as in this plane. Mundus. Tamriel. Nearby. Relatively speaking, on the cosmological scale, well, it's all nearby. One block lifts the other. Septimus will give what you want, but you must bring him something in return.
Okay.
You see this masterwork of the Dwemer, deep inside their greatest knowings. Septimus is clever among men, but he is but an idiot child compared to the dullest of the Dwemer. Lucky then they left behind their own way of reading the Elder Scrolls. In the depths of Black Reach, one yet lies. Have you heard of Black Reach? Cast upon where Drimmer City slept, the yearning spire hidden learnings kept. Under deep, below the dark, the hidden keep, Tower of Zark. Oftan, the point of puncture, of first entry of the tapping. Delve to its limits, and Black Reach lies just beyond.
Place.
But not all can enter
My
there.
Brother.
Only Septimus knows the hidden key to loose the lock, to jump beneath the deathly rock. Two things I have for you. Two shapes. One edged, one round. The round one for tuning. Dwemer music is soft and subtle, and needed to open their cleverest gates. The edged lexicon for inscribing. To us, a hunk of metal. To the Dwemer, a full library of knowings, but empty. Prime Mazar and its Sky Dome. The machinations there will read the scroll and lay the lore upon the cube. Trust Septimus. He knows you can know.
This guy. Don't know how I feel about it. Fast travel to Sarfall. So I'm using a lot of mods on this game. Now it's a you sort of have to do that with Argonians. Unfortunately, the vanilla Argonians in Skyrim are pretty terrible. So, a lot of my mods revolve around just, making them not look bad. But, there's some other things too, like for example on the interface, I have a great mod, wish I knew what it was called so that I could give them a bit of free advertising, but I have a mod that tells you if a place is important for a particular quest so that you don't do it before you do the quest. It's very useful. Very, very useful. We'll see it, for example, Sarfall says Quest College of Winterhold, because it's part of the College of Winterhold quest line. So it would suck if you played through it and then had to do it again for the College of Winterhold. We're going to check out Mount Amphor right now. Hopefully I can find my way there. Wait. Stray dog. Oh, those aren't stray dogs, though. Alright, guys, check out my great... check out my great mage powers. Well, somebody shot one of them. But, that dog likes me, but I don't want it to get hurt by the cold. That must be the dragon that lives up there. Closer, I'm gonna throw iron flesh on. Since it sucks up so much health. So much magic. There you go. See how much it takes from me? What is this? What? This dog? This dog has joined me. What the heck? That's kind of cool. Okay. I'll take that. That's cool. Okay, so the dragon's gotta be around here somewhere. I saw him. There it is. There it is. Let's take it out live on camera. Hopefully I don't die. Oh, I missed that. I hope it doesn't kill that dog. It's kind of nice. Yeah, you tell him, Flannel. Go with that.
A healing spell? Are you a priest?
This dog is too powerful for an adept level conjuration spell. Wow. I really lost something there.
Okay. Still here? I'm a mage, not a pawnbroker, you know.
I'm gonna have you carry.
Let's get going then.
Jeez. Okay. So. What delicious treasures lie in wait for us here? Hey, I'm almost level 33. That's pretty great. Let's see. Yes. Oh, actually, that doesn't sound too bad. Okie dokie. Custom marker. That must be the Shrine of Azura that I'm seeing over there. Okay, let's see. Burnt corpse? Part of this complete practice. Oh. Alk, you know, after fighting a dragon, there's nothing I would want more than to engage in some alchemy. I I bet this road takes me straight to off. I can't believe my dog died. That is so tragic. That is a real tragedy. Let's see what's up over yonder. I am quite the adventurer, or the explorer. I just love exploring in this game. It's what drew me into Skyrim in the first place. Oh, wow. Hello there. Never waste a good excuse to use your healing. Yeah, let's go get that fort. You know what Xenoblade Chronicles X has that this game just really lacks? Points for discovering things, or experience for discovering things. If they had experience for discovering things in Skyrim, I would be so happy. Can I even get one there? That looks like beyond my reach. Let's go check it out dramatically. Oh my god, it's a dragon. Oh, and it's fighting something. Oh, isn't that cute? That's like right along the road or something. I see. There's a road that diverges up this way. Let's take a custom mark. Check it out later. Okay, but it looks like if I keep taking the way that I'm going, let me get up to the Shrine of Oz. That'd be worth having on the map. Make me feel like I'm in Rio. That giant statue. I can't for the love of me get into Elder Scrolls lore, so I don't really know who Azura is. Whoa, Frost Troll. Hey, howdy, hey there. Come back here, you rapscallion. Why, yes, it is the Shrine of Azura. I wonder if there are any naughties around here. Da-da-da! Star Fox Adventures. Oh, there's somebody up here. Oh, didn't see that coming. Well, I've been here. On another
playthrough. We are children of the twilight. Beings who are to be guided from the darkness into the light. And from the light into darkness.
It's been about 30 minutes of footage. Seems like a good time to cut off the footage and start anew from a newer video. Thank you for watching my very first Let's Play video with sound. Hopefully, I don't know how the sound or how my voice sounds on this video. Hopefully it's at least somewhat audible. Thank you for watching.